हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। दिस इज ऋषभ एंड आई एम गोइंग टू रीड ओनली फॉर यू ऑल गाइस ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द चैप्टर्स ऑफ 9th ICSE। सो लेट्स बिगिन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू रीड एंड एक्सप्लेन टू यू ऑल द पोयम कोल्ड विद इन। सो आई जस्ट फर्स्टली स्टार्ट विद द जिस्ट ऑफ द पोयम। कोल्ड विद इन इज अ पोयम रिटन बाय अमेरिकन पोएट James Patrick. The poem is pointed on comment on the lack of warmth and compassion in human relations. There are six people. None of the six people who by chance are trapped in the bitter cold agree to put their sticks in the food fire. The poem, through the discriminator acts of six humans, tries to depict the attitudes of human being in general. So now let's start reading. The Cold Within. Six humans trapped by happenstance. Happenstance, something that happens by chance. In bleak and bitter cold, which means unpleasant. Each one possessed a stick of wood, which means setting. Or so the story told. So first stanza explains us that six humans are trapped together by the chance of bitter cold. Each of them has a stick of wood. So this forms the setting of the poem, and against this background the story is narrated. Stanza 2. They are dying fire in needs of logs. This is a personification. But the first one held hers back. Four of the faces round the fire, she noticed one was black. So firstly, it is extremely cold and the fire that is keeping them warm is dying. So this is explained in the first line. They are dying fire in needs of logs, which means that the fire which is keeping them warm is dying, which means there is very less wood left, so it would die. It can be kept lighted only if one of them puts its log to use. Among of the six people, if someone puts their logs in that fire, then only the fire would not die. The first man is prejudiced. When he notices that one of the faces round the fire is black, he therefore holds his log back. So in this stanza, racial discrimination, racism against black and white is shown. The next man, looking across the way, saw one knot of his church and could not bring himself to grip the fire his stick of birch. Birch is a tree. So stanza 3 explains us that there was another man, when he looks across the way, he found that one of them does not belong to his same church, which means the same religious community, as is. This fact stops him from putting his stick. So in this stanza, there was a religion discrimination. Stanza 4. The third one sat in tattered clothes. He gave his coat a hitch. Why should his log be put to use to warm the idle rich? The first line is specifying on poor. Tattered means torn. Hitch means just pulled it closer to his chest or his body. So the fourth stanza explains us that the third one is a poor man. He sits in his tattered clothes. To protect himself from the freezing cold, he gives his coat a hitch, but does not use the lock to prevent a rich man sitting there from getting warm. Fifth stanza. The rich man just sat back and thought of the wealth he had in store and how to keep what he had earned from the lazy, shiftless poor. Shiftless poor means lacking ambition. So this stanza explains us that the rich man, on the other hand, thinks of his wealth he has in his store and how he could keep it safe from the poor man. The black man's face bespoke revenge as the fire passed from his sight, for all he saw in his stick of wood was a chance to spite the white. Bespoke revenge matlab spoke of revenge. Spite, desire to harm. Stanza 6 explanation. The black man's face looks revengeful, and the only thing he could see is the stick is a chance by which the white man can get warm. So he wanted to harm the white man. Stanza 7. The last man of his forlorn group did not accept for gain. Giving only to those who gave was how he played the game. So he was self-centered. He thought that if somebody gave him something, so he will give that back. Forlorn, sad or lonely. Stanza 7 explanation. The last man of his lonely group does nothing except something for his benefit. So the person mentioned in stanza 7 is selfish. He gives only to those who gives him back something. Last stanza. Their locks held tight in death's still hands was proof of human sin. They did not die from the cold without, they died from the cold within. Their locks, which were held tight in their hands, they invited death. This is the proof of human sin. So none of them put their log in the fire, so the fire died. And the six people die not from the freezing cold outside, but the cold within them. Themes of the poem Cold Within. Futility of discrimination. The poem deals with the theme of futility of discrimination or hatred that humans have against one another. The poem projects discrimination based on race, class and religion by narrating the story of six individuals who are caught together by chance in extreme cold. The people in the poem are from different backgrounds and religion. Owing to their prejudices against one another, it becomes difficult for them to put their stick into the fire. The discrimination, racism and bigotry proves futile as none of the six people stay alive by the end. Each perishes not because of the cold outside but the cold-heartedness within each. Lack of warmth in human relations. The six men in the poem can be seen as representatives of the whole human race. It is said that these men are overtaken by the feelings of revenge, spite and anger to such an extent that eventually these prejudices lead to their downfall. The six humans are devoid of humanity and even when they are going through the same situation, they cannot cooperate. Warmth and compassion for each other is not seen in them. Each one of them has a log that can be put to use, not only for others but also for themselves. However, their differences surpass their survival instinct. The lack of warmth is best expressed in the line, "Their dying fire in need of logs." Literally, it refers to the fire that is dying and needs to be kept alive with the use of log. Metaphorically, it can be understood as the fire of compassion in their hearts that is dying. To keep it burning, what they need is a log of wood, but they do not use it. Thus, by the end, each one of them dies from the cold within. Outside cold could have been taken care of only if they were not cold from within. We will discuss the question and answers of this poem in the next video. Till then, stay home, stay safe, and goodbye.